Hi viewer, I welcome you to your interview. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 4, lesson number 6. The topic is land reclamation and rehabilitation. I'm your tutor, Lucy. Welcome. Our lesson goes, we are going to look at them when we look at the benefit of Pakera irrigation scheme. At number two, we look at the problems facing Pakera irrigation scheme. We start by looking at the benefit of the Pakera irrigation scheme. One of the benefits or one of the advantages, we have the scheme as made unproductive land to become productive land. Initially, this area where we have the Pakera irrigation scheme was there was no product that was coming out from this place. Why? It is because of the floods. But the time when Pakera irrigation scheme was started, it couldn't use the excess water that was flooding in the area. So it was able to check the flooding. So as a result, now you can see the unproductive part of the land is becoming productive. Number two, it has resulted in rising the standard of living of their people due to earning of the income to their farmers. How does this one come? When a farmer plants melons, plants cotton, when you plant onions and also the pawpaws, tomatoes, maize, beets, they are selling them and yet they are getting income. So as a result, they can get what they don't produce. So in that case, it is raising the standard of living. Number three, it has resulted to the settlement of landless people. So these 350 hectares that have been developed since 1954, you get that people who are landless, they were resettled in this place. So now you see the people who are landless could get somewhere to stay. It has also resulted in the development of the infrastructure. We have the feeder roads, that are connecting to the Pakera irrigation scheme have developed. This is because the farmers need to take their product to the market. The pawpaws are supposed to get to the market. Cotton is supposed to get to the GND. We also have the pawpaws. They need to get to the people who feed on them. So as a result, there is that development of the infrastructure. And number five, it has resulted to the development of the social amenities. Social amenities like the schools, hospitals. We also have the churches. We also have the mosque. We also have the recreation centers that have been developed, that have been started in Baringo County just because of Pakera irrigation scheme. This is because the people who do work in this irrigation scheme, they require the hospitals, they require the schools. They also need the recreation centers. They also need the churches to join. So you get that there is that development. And number six, it has created employment opportunities. We have a number of people who are working in this program. Doing their farming, harvesting, the drivers who are employed to take their product to the market. They are also there, they are employed. So it has opened up employment opportunities to many. What are the problems? Yes, it has the benefit, but also there are the problems that are facing the Pakera irrigation scheme. Number one, we have inadequate supply of water, which has hindered the production of the perishable crops. due to the instability of the climate and also the high rate of the water being used by the farmers for the irrigation, it has reduced the water in Pakera River. So as a result, that water is not adequate to serve the 2,350 hectares that was gazetted in 1954. So that is a problem. Number two, we have inadequate market of guns produced since the surround areas are sparsely populated. So if I look at the Baringo County, it is sparsely populated. So you happen to get that the melons, the fruit, and also even the onions that are being produced in this place, they don't get a ready market within the surrounding. They need to get to the other places. So now you get there is a problem for the production of perishable crops. And the third one, we have the poor transport communication, transport and communication network, since the area is in a remote area. Baringo County, it is not a county that has developed. It is a remote county, a remote area. So as a result, you get that infrastructure, the communication networks are poorly developed. So there is also another problem, which are hindering the taking of the crops to the market, even the getting of the fertilizer and even the getting of other services is becoming a problem. The assignment for today, you're supposed to state 4 benefits of Pakera irrigation scheme. And number two, you state 4 problems facing Pakera irrigation scheme. For more information, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 4, that edition, or you can get us through the following. You can contact us through the SMSing to the number. You can also get us through the YouTube. You can also get us through the Facebook. You can also get us or Twitter us through that. Otherwise, stay tuned to your interview. Thank you.